Have you ever wanted something really bad and tried really hard to get it, but it just didn't work out for you? What if, instead of failing at the thing you could see, you were really succeeding at something else you couldn't see? That very strange thing happens to a little boy in this Read Aloud with Mr. Paul. Welcome to Read Aloud with Mr. Paul. I'm so glad you could be here. Today, we'll be reading The Empty Pot by Demi. Here's our title page, The Empty Pot by Demi. Here is the dedication page. The author and illustrator dedicates the book to CZ Jesse Huang. A long time ago in China, there was a boy named Ping who loved flowers. Anything he planted burst into bloom. Up came flowers, bushes, even big fruit trees as if by magic. Everyone in the kingdom loved flowers too. They planted them everywhere and the air smelled like perfume. The emperor loved birds and animals, but flowers most of all, and he tended his own garden every day. But the emperor was very old. He needed to choose a successor to the throne. Who would his successor be? And how would the emperor choose? Because the emperor loved flowers so much, he decided to let the flowers choose. The next day, a proclamation was issued. All the children in the land were to come to the palace. There, they would be given special flower seeds by the emperor. Whoever can show me their best in a year's time, he said, will succeed me to the throne. This news created great excitement throughout the land. Children from all over the country swarmed to the palace to get their flower seeds. All the parents wanted their children to be chosen emperor, and all the children hoped they would be chosen too. When Ping received his seed from the emperor, he was the happiest child of all. He was sure he could grow the most beautiful flower. Ping filled a flower pot with rich soil. He planted the seed in it very carefully. He watered it every day. He couldn't wait to see it sprout, grow, and blossom into a beautiful flower. Day after day passed. But nothing grew in his pot. Ping was very worried. He put new soil into a bigger pot. Then he transferred the seed into the rich black soil. Another 2 months he waited. Still, nothing happened. By and by, the whole year passed. Spring came, and all the children put on their best clothes to greet the emperor. They rushed to the palace with their beautiful flowers, eagerly hoping to be chosen. Ping was ashamed of his empty pot. He thought the other children would laugh at him because for once, he couldn't get a flower to grow. His clever friend ran by, holding a great big plant. "Ping," he said. "You're not really going to the emperor with an empty pot, are you? Couldn't you grow a great big flower like mine?" "I've grown lots of flowers better than yours," Ping said. "It's just this seed that won't grow." Ping's father overheard this and said, "You did your best, and your best is good enough to present to the emperor." Holding the empty pot in his hands, Ping went straight away to the palace. The emperor was looking at the flowers slowly, one by one. How beautiful all the flowers were! But the emperor was frowning and did not say a word. Finally, he came to Ping. Ping hung his head in shame, expecting to be punished. The emperor asked him, "Why did you bring an empty pot?" Ping started to cry and replied, I planted the seed you gave me, and I watered it every day, but it didn't sprout. I put it in a better pot with better soil, but still it didn't sprout. I tended it all year long, but nothing grew. So today I had to bring an empty pot without a flower. It was the best I could do. When the emperor heard these words, a smile slowly spread over his face, and he put his arm around Ping. Then he exclaimed to one and all, "I have found him! I have found the one person worthy of being emperor! Where you got your seeds from, I do not know, for the seeds I gave you had all been cooked, so it was impossible for any of them to grow." I admire Ping's great courage to appear before me with the empty truth. And now I reward him with my entire kingdom and make him emperor of all the land. What do we notice about this story? One thing I notice is how many children are willing to cheat to try and become emperor. And I don't think it's just the kids either. When their seeds didn't grow, I bet most of them went to their parents, who helped them to plant different seeds in their pots, or gave them fully grown plants to take to the emperor. This story shows us how many people are willing to cheat to get what they want, especially when the prize is so great. That makes Ping's honesty even more important. And it shows us a second quality Ping has. It takes courage to face the embarrassment of failure. It takes courage to be honest when others are lying and cheating, and when their lying and cheating seems to be working. That's a special kind of courage called moral courage. Ping has this moral courage, and this also sets him apart from everyone else. The emperor was wise to create a test that would expose honesty and moral courage. These are qualities a good leader should have. And his test showed just how rare these qualities are. Do you have honesty and moral courage? I hope so. Thank you so much for joining me for Read Aloud with Mr. Paul. Until next time, discover the wonder in a book. Pick one up. Take a look.
If you enjoyed this Read Aloud with Mr. Paul, please like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. Thanks again.